In this video, I'm going to be sharing a really simple technique which will help you speak the language you're learning with more confidence. Hi, I'm Mark from Coffee Break Languages, and this morning on my coffee break, I thought I would talk a little bit about a technique which I use all the time when I'm speaking one of the languages I'm learning. I'm sure, like me, you've experienced that situation where you're a bit nervous about speaking in the language. So you've thought carefully about what you're going to say. You've mastered the phrase or the question you're going to ask. And the moment arrives for you to utter those words. And you manage it almost perfectly. Well, maybe your pronunciation could have been a bit better. But from the look on the face of the person you're speaking to, they've understood you. Result. That is until you hear the reply, and it's not quite what you were expecting. It's not what was written in your textbook or the sample conversation you've listened to. In fact, this is one of the most common challenges we hear about here at Coffee Break Languages. You can say things, but understanding responses is a whole different story. So how do you combat this feeling of inadequacy? How do you prepare for all eventualities? I think the key is in anticipating what someone may say in response to your statement or question. And by that, I mean all the possible responses. In fact, I actually like to try to work out multiple options before I get to the point of speaking in the first place. Of course, this isn't rocket science. Our brain is doing this in our native language all the time. And we can react quickly to information, even when we don't expect it. But when it comes to a new language, the language we're learning, it's a different story. We need to train our brain to make those connections. Okay, it may help to look at an example. Imagine you are making a phone call to check on the delivery of a parcel that you've sent to your friend. You want to find out why the parcel has not yet been delivered. You need to anticipate some of the possible responses to your question. For example, what if the parcel is being held at customs? Now, do you know the verb to hold? Is being held as a passive structure, and there's a chance that this kind of explanation may well be said in the passive because the person or organisation who's doing the holding isn't really important. It's the fact that it's being held that's important. But are you ready to understand that passive structure? Don't worry too much about this. The fact is, you probably will recognise the verb, and if you recognise the verb, the chances are you'll be able to guess the passive meaning. But are you familiar with the word for customs? What if the parcel has been lost? It's not good for you or your friend to find out that the parcel has been lost. Hopefully it'll be found. But do you know the word for lost? Does to lose have an irregular past participle in the language you're learning? And most importantly, do you know how to react with a mamma mia or oh la la when you discover that it's been lost? Here's another possibility. The delivery drivers are on strike. Would you know how to understand the verb to strike? Will there be more information given? For example, will you be listening for a day of the week or a date when the strike will be over? What else? Import charges have to be paid. So import charges is quite a technical bit of vocabulary, which you may not necessarily know. But I'm sure the chances are you'll recognise the verb to pay. In this case, you may need to follow up with a question about whether you can pay over the phone in order to clear the package for delivery. So you may want to make sure that you can formulate that kind of question. Of course, there are many other possible situations or explanations for the parcel not being delivered. And of course, we could take this much further. It may also seem that this whole process is quite time consuming, quite long. But I think there are two things that we need to focus on here. First of all, your brain can work a lot more quickly than the speed of this video. I'm sure that as you've watched me talking about these different scenarios, you'll already have thought up a number of other scenarios. Secondly, and perhaps maybe even more importantly, you know you. You know what you already know. So you can skip quickly through some parts of the anticipation process and just focus on any new words or phrases you may need to learn. I'll let you into a little secret. This whole process is exactly what I had to do a couple of weeks ago when I had to call the Madrid office of UPS. You may have seen some of our Q&A videos in which we answer your questions. I was sending some Coffee Break Spanish t-shirts to Marina, along with some equipment for her to film her parts of the video in Spain. However, I'd posted the parcel 10 weeks previously and it still hadn't reached her in Cordoba. Now, according to Google Maps, I could have walked from Scotland to Cordoba and back in less time. So I wasn't too pleased. Anyway, I was about to phone the Madrid UPS office. Now, I'm fairly confident in Spanish, but I'd still given some thought to the various possible scenarios to make sure I was ready to deal with the conversation. However, what I didn't expect was the person I spoke to clearly had some kind of Guinness World Record for being the fastest speaker of Spanish alive. No matter how many times I asked him to slow down or repeat things, he just kept firing off this ricochet of supersonic Spanish, which was completely impossible to understand. So even with anticipation and planning, it's not always easy. I have to say that I was quite relieved when Marina herself called the same number later that day and found the man equally impossible to understand. Quite a relief. So what do you think? Do you go through this anticipation process when you're preparing a conversation or a phone call? Or do you just go for it and hope for the best? I'd love to read your comments. Let me know too if you'd like me to make more of these videos. I'd also like to suggest that you subscribe to our newsletter. You'll get weekly language learning tips from me and monthly updates from the team with lesson updates, reading texts in the language you're learning, and cultural information. Go to coffeebreaklanguages.com/newsletter or click the link which you should see up here. That's it for this video. If you've enjoyed it, make sure you give it a like and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more help and inspiration for your language learning. By the way, you'll be pleased to know that the t-shirts did finally reach Marina after being held at customs, then lost for 3 weeks, and we did have import fees to pay as well. But I suppose we should be thankful that there wasn't a strike to add to the list of problems. Thank you for watching. Happy language learning, and of course, happy coffee breaking.